present. It is really a special honor for me to address the National Press Club.
To be confident, as the expenditure is under control.
The commitment to the Atlantic Alliance is the basis for defense and security in Europe. Even the members of the Union that are not part of NATO share this view with us. But time has come to look for and to build a European identity for defense and security within the alliance, not replacing the alliance, and contributing to strengthen the alliance. The United States are the sole remaining superpower. Of course, it's better to be alone than in bad company. But hermits excluded, I dare say every man and woman would share the view that it's even better to be in good company than alone. I think Europe should assume a stronger share of responsibility in matters of defense and security, not only in what respects our own defense, but also in promoting peace and stability in the world together with the United States. Partnership with Russia and Ukraine is a rich concept, but when trying to express an ultimate stage of mutual trust and cooperation between countries, I rather prefer to use the word alliance. As a final goal, an ultimate state of mutual trust, not a first step. An alliance based on the values of enlightenment. The values of enlightenment that are our basic guarantee against all forms of irrationality, of exacerbated nationalism, of xenophobia and racism, of religious fundamentalism. This is the alliance I would like to have in the 21st century. Of alliance of all peoples that share the same values of enlightenment and rationality in dealing with world affairs.